This complicated neural network image is taken from Google's multilingual neural machine translation system, enabling zero-shot translation paper. This solution enables Google Translate to generate a reasonable translation between two languages that it has never been taught to do so. And it does it with a new language that it created. Now, before the AI was creating new languages to communicate, humans were defining how computers are going to communicate between each other, and one of those languages is the SPI, or the Serial Peripheral Interface. Here we can see and understand what the MCU is sending to its peripherals and decode it. Let's start with the concept. It is synchronous and full-duplex. Synchronous means that this interface uses different lines for data and a clock. This ensures that both sides, the MCU and the peripherals, are in perfect sync. Full-duplex means that the SPI has separate lines for sending and receiving information, and in certain situations can transmit and receive data at the same time. Keep in mind that this interface can have just one controller and one or multiple peripherals. This means one MCU controls other ICs and sensors. There exist 3-wire or 4-wire SPI configurations. The 3-wire configuration has just one data line, while the 4-wire has two. Today we are going to focus on the more popular one, the 4-wire devices, which have these pins: the clock, the chip select, master out slave in, and master in slave out. The clock signal is generated only by the MCU, then the data is synchronized to the clock generated by the same MCU. The chip select pin is used to select the peripheral that you want to talk to, because there can be a lot of them, trust me. It is normally an active low when you want to transfer the data, and is pull high to disconnect the sensor from the SPI bus. MISO is for receiving data from the peripheral to the MCU, and MOSI is for sending information to the sensor from the MCU. Arduino boards like this one also support the SPI interface and has the following connections, so actually it depends on the type of the Arduino board that you have. Now, using an Arduino board, we can connect a sensor to it or an IC and examine. By connecting oscilloscope probes to the data wires, we can clearly see right from the start that the controller selects peripherals by pulling down the CS line. When that line is active low, data through MOSI flows to the subnode. If the subnode needs to send feedback, MCU will continue to generate another number of clock cycles until the signal through MISO will come back to the controller. In the end, the CS line brought up back to end the communication. Oh, by the way, this BK Precision digital storage oscilloscope is perfect for decoding and other debugging situations, and guess what? You can find it on our website tme.eu. But not only! In TME, you will find hundreds of thousands of products from trusted brands with high stock levels, and 96% of the orders are taken care on the same day. So what are you waiting for? Go to tme.eu right now! Or after this video. Both. Alright, let's go back for a second to the clock signal. In SPI, the controller can not only generate a clock signal, but also select the polarity and the phase. Polarity bit sets the clock signal either normally low or normally high. The phase bit selects whether to sample or shift the data on the rising or the falling clock edge. Because of these two bits, SPI is divided into four modes. In mode 0, clock polarity is normally low and high when communication occurs. Data is sampled on the rising edge and shifted on the falling one. In mode 1, clock stays the same while data is sampled on the falling edge and shifted on the rising. In modes 2 and 3, clock polarity is opposite. Normally it is high and low when communicating. In mode 2, data is read on the falling edge, while in mode 3, on the rising. Shifting of the data works vice versa. But why do we need this table of modes? Well, it has to do with the requirements of the peripherals. Take this 8x8 LED matrix as an example. If we go to this really amazing datasheet, we can clearly see that it supports mode 0, which means that communicating through other modes is not possible. Overall, SPI is great. It features high-speed synchronous data transfer and pretty straightforward slave addressing system, despite it requiring more signal wires, having one master device, and working on short wires.